Primarily, there are two methods of boiling, the floating system and sunken system. The boiling methods under the floating system are open pan cooking and two or three pan cooking. The cocoons boiled by these methods tend to float on water during the process of reeling, and hence the name floating system of reeling. The boiling methods under the sunken system are pressurized cooking boiling, cocoon boiling and conveyor type of boiling. The cocoons boiled by these methods remain sunk in water during the process of reeling, and hence the name sunken system of reeling. Open pan cooking method. This is the most primitive and conventional method of cocoon boiling. The process of boiling, namely permeation, cooking and adjusting, are all carried out simultaneously in the same bath where the water is maintained at very high temperature ranging from 90 to 95 degrees centigrade. The equipment consists of a cylindrical vessel either made of copper, aluminium, brass or stainless steel, mounted on the edge of a metal table which is connected by steam pipe or masonry construction built into a hearth for heating. Water is filled into the vessel up to 3/4 level and is heated indirectly by steam or directly by burning fuel in the hearth. Open pan cocoon boiling method. When the water temperature reaches 90 to 95 degrees centigrade, that is just before it boils, a handful of cocoons, about 50 to 60, are put into the vessel and work with the help of a perforated ladle of ensure that all the cocoons are immersed in water. When the cocoons are immersed into a high temperature water bath, sarrasin on the outer layer of the cocoon shell is swollen and swarfen, and water enters the capillary pores. During the same time, the air inside the shell cavity gets heated and expands, and the expand air try to escape through the same pores, and the pores get blocked, arresting the movement of air and water. This results in only a small quantity of water getting into the shell cavity. The duration of the treatment of the cocoon in the bath is most important factor, as it determines the level of the sarrasin swelling of the silk filament in open pan cocoon cooking system. Controlling the level of swelling and permeation of the water into the cavity is difficult because the outer shell layers soften earlier than the inner layers, and the pores get blocked and does not allow the water to get inside the shell easily. Generally, the time taken for cooking is 2 to 4 minutes based on the thickness of the cocoon shell and the experience of the operator. The advantages of the cocoon open pan cooking are listed below. It is economical as the investment is very less. Boiling is by direct heating using locally available cheap fuel or even bio-waste material, thereby avoiding the requirement of boilers for steam generation. The reeler can be aware of the quality of the cooked cocoons. The disadvantages of these methods of boiling are also listed below. It is a batch process. Variation in the level of cocoon softening takes place from batch to batch. It is a skillful operation and requires an experienced operator. It is suitable only for inferior quality of multi-hybrid and multi-Walton cocoons. The quality of raw silk is inferior as overboiling results in the increase of slubs in the yarn, increase in the cleanness and neatness defects of the yarn, and reduction in the reeling efficiency. Underboiling reduces the reelability, thereby leading to uneven silk yarn. Yarn tension is increased and elongation of the yarn is reduced. Constant supervision is necessary to control the silk waste, and wastage of reeling cocoon is due to over or under boiling of the cocoons. Raw silk yield is affected. As cocoon boiling and brushing takes place in the same pan, water gets turbid very soon and the chemical constituents of the cocoon and pupae gets into the water, hence need to replenish the turbid water with fresh water very frequently. If it is not done, it affects the raw silk quality. In spite of the disadvantages, open pan cooking method is the most common method of the cocoon boiling in India. This method of boiling is also a batch process, but larger quantity of cocoons, 2 to 3 kgs, can be processed by using either 2 or 3 pans. With the principle of boiling being the same, the process was further improved by incorporating suitable modification to change from 3 pans to 2 pan system of cooking. The process is based on the principle that the air in the shell cavity heats up and expands. As the expanded air comes out of the shell, it creates a partial vacuum when cooled with water at low temperature, thus causing the water permeation into the shell cavity. In this method, permeation of water into the shell cavity is caused by the temperature difference inside and outside the cocoon. Three pan method. The equipments of the three cylindrical metallic vessels with the steam and the water connections. The cocoons are processed in a cylindrical perforated cage having a long handle at one end, and the other end with a cage is a lid with a latch. The cage is filled with cocoons, is immersed into the first pan for 1 to 1.5 minutes, where the temperature of water is maintained at about 90 to 95 degrees centigrade. Due to the high temperature, the air in the shells get heated and expanded. The expanded air comes out of the cocoon. Air inside the cocoon is expelled. The cage is then briskly shifted into the second pan with a bath temperature of 60 to 70 degrees centigrade and maintained at 30 to 40 seconds. Due to the lower temperature, air in the shell cavity contracts and sucks the water to replace the expelled air. When the cage is shifted into the third pan with a bath temperature of 90 to 95 degrees centigrade temperature, the high temperature again heats up the water permeated into the shell cavity, thereby softening the sericin in the cocoon layers. Cocoons are processed in the third pan for 1.5 to 2 minutes before the cocoons are brushed for gathering the filament ends. This method is defective as the cocoons are exposed to high temperature initially in the first pan, which causes blockage of the movement of the air and water. Two pan method. By modifying the three pan process, the two pan method of boiling has been developed. The processing method consists of soaking, permeation, boiling and adjusting the cooked cocoons. This method of cocoon cooking can be set up in units which has a boiler and the facility to maintain the temperature of water in the pans. the advantages of the system of boiling are: 1. Softening and swelling of the sarrasin in all the shell layers can be achieved. Number 2. Cooking can be controlled by controlling the temperature of the bath and duration of the cooking. 3. Hot air dried cocoons can be boiled to get better reeling results. Number 4. Quality of the raw silk improves. And number 5. Silk waste is reduced. The disadvantages are: number 1. Slightly high expenditure as a steam generator is required. 2. Batch process. 3. Skilled operator is required for maintaining the required temperature in each pan. Number 4. Only small quantity of cocoons can be processed as per the batch, since it is difficult to handle large quantity of cocoons. It is an improved system of cooking and is adopted in the reeling units where advanced reeling machines are deployed. Cocoons are boiled either in a batch process or in a continuous process. In smaller capacity units, cocoon boiling can be carried out in batch process. The circular cocoon boiling machine. This is a batch type of pressurized boiling machine. The equipment consists of a cylinder with a lid mounted on a stand, cocoon cages provided in the cylinder with provision for lifting and lowering of the cages within the cylinder placed on the platform. The cylinder is connected with water and steam connections. Water in the cylinder is filled so as to cover the cage and the cylinder and heated by steam to a temperature of 50 to 60 degrees centigrade. Cocoon cages are immersed in this water for about 60 seconds and the cages are raised above the water level. With the lid closed, steam is passed into the cylinder to increase the temperature to about 95 degrees centigrade and the cocoons are treated for 2 minutes. The heat expands the air and the shell cavity and it is expelled out. Once again, the cocoons are immersed into the water bath where the temperature of the water is increased to 60 to 70 degrees centigrade. Cocoons are maintained in this bath for 45 to 60 seconds. The cage is lifted up once again and the steam at a temperature of 98 to 100 degrees centigrade for about 2 to 2.5 minutes. After steam cooking, the cocoons are again lowered into water for 1 minute where the temperature has been increased to 90 degrees centigrade. After this stage, cold water is sprayed into the cages to gradually bring down the water temperature from 90 degrees to 50 degrees centigrade in about 5 to 7 minutes. The whole process of soaking, steaming, permeation, steam cooking and adjusting is completed in about 11 to 14 minutes depending on the quality of the cocoons. Such a boiling machines are suitable for small units where good quality cocoons and hot air dried and processed for producing good quality raw silk yarn. This is the commonly used cocoon boiling machine in the reeling units having automatic and semi-automatic reeling machines. Good quality bivoltaic cocoons are best suited for processing in this type of machines to produce better quality raw silk. The process of continuous and is suitable for units is producing the large quantity of raw silk per day. The machine consists of a series of water baths through which the cocoons are carried in baskets fitted to an endless conveyor chain. The water baths are zones through which cocoons are passed are soaking or wetting zone, high temperature zone, permeation or low temperature zone, steaming cooking zone, adjusting zone and finishing zone. Soaking or wetting zone. In this zone, cocoons are soaked in warm, mild, hot water. Cocoons filled with conveyor baskets are first immersed into the water bath, maintained between 45 to 65 degrees centigrade for 1 to 1.5 minutes to 3 minutes, enabling to soak the outer layer of the cocoon shell as the pre-treatment for the boiling process. This is necessary as the cocoons are dried, the moisture content in the filament is very low and the water absorbency of the sericin is low. Such dry cocoons are wetted as the water penetration into the shell is difficult without it being moist. Hence, in order to make the shell moist and thereby enabling the permeation of water into the cavity, the cocoons are soaked. High temperature zone. Cocoons which are wetted are treated at high temperatures, steaming zone, in order to permeate water into the cocoon shell. It is necessary for the temperature in the zone to be regulated depending on the cocoons. For cocoons with a thick shell layer but poor reliability, the temperature is maintained at 100 degrees centigrade, and for thin shell layer, the good reliability cocoons, the temperature is maintained at 97 to 98 degrees centigrade. Number 3. Permeation or low temperature zone. The steam cocoons are immediately immersed into the low temperature permeation bath, where the temperature difference between this zone and the previous zone is lowered by 25 to 35 degrees centigrade. In this chamber, the steam which had entered the cocoon shell is condensed. The water enters inside the cocoon cavity as there is a pressure difference created between outside and inside of the cocoon shell. Steam cooking zone. This treatment is considered as the nucleus in the cocoon boiling process. The degree of swelling, the sericin, the quality of water absorbed into the shell cavity, the extent of silk waste generation is dependent on the temperature maintained in this part of cocoon boiling process. The steam cooking zone performs two operations. First, water in the cocoon cavity permeated in the previous part is drained out, and second, the wetting cocoon layer are steamed to swell and soften sericin in the cocoon layers. The amount of water expelled in the steaming zone can be calculated by the formula. Quantity of water expelled is equal to x by y into z, where x is equal to water outflow per minute, y is the number of cocoons per cage, and z number of cages moving in the zone per minute. Number 5. Adjusting zone. In this zone, cocoons are treated for the longest duration, which is about 20 to 24% of the total time of cooking. Generally, cocoons are treated in this zone for 2.5 to 5 minutes. This zone consists of two parts. The sericin is allowed to swell in the first part and condense back onto the filament in the second part. The temperature is adjusted such that it is gradually reduced from the steaming zone about 100 degrees centigrade to a low temperature of 40 degrees centigrade at the finishing zone. Number 6. Finishing zone. This is the last part of the cocoon boiling machine, where cocoons are treated at a temperature of 40 degrees centigrade to 45 degrees centigrade for about 1.5 to 2 minutes. At this stage, the weight of the cocoon shell is increased to 10 times of its dry weight. The cocoon cages are lifted out of the water bath, and the cocoons are delivered into a receptacle along with the water. Cocoon boiling machines are commonly used in sericulturally advanced countries. In India, such machines are imported and installed in a few government villages. Permeation of water into the shell cavity is also obtained by creating a negative pressure, that is vacuum, outside the cocoon. Due to the pressure difference, air is sucked out of the cocoon shell cavity, is filled up by water. The soaked cocoons are cooked in steam to bring out uniform welling and softening of the sericin in all the layers of the shell. The amount of sericin loss and cocoon pellet layer waste is reduced and raw silk yield is increased. Dry cocoons are put in a large cylindrical drum connected to a vacuum pump. Air is sucked out of the cylinder by creating a vacuum pressure of 550 to 650 mmHg. Then water at 40 to 55 degrees is let into the cylinder until the vacuum pressure is reduced to 120 mmHg and air is allowed inside. The procedure is repeated 2 or 3 times based on the quality of the cocoons. By this operation, water moves into and out of the cocoons freely, soaking all the layers of the cocoon shell uniformly. The soaked cocoons are then transferred into a cocoon boiling machine, which is modified to suit boiling of the water imbibed cocoons. The cocoon boiling is carried out for 5 to 7 minutes. The procedure consists of the following steps: cocoon pre-treatment at 60 to 70 degrees centigrade, water exhaust at 100 degrees centigrade, water steam cooking at 100 degrees centigrade, static storage cocoon treatment at 90 to 95 degrees centigrade, finishing at 40 degrees centigrade. Vacuum type of cocoon cooking is common in Chinese silk reeling industry. Preservation of cooked cocoons. After boiling, the cooked cocoons have to be taken up and kept in appropriate containers until the next process. The cocoons have to be kept in a water bath where the water temperature is maintained between 30 degrees to 40 degrees. The cooked cocoons have to be reeled as early as possible. If not, the water in which it is kept will turn acidic due to the chemicals released from the pupae, thereby reducing the reelability.